I just find fame to be really weird. I just never wanted it, never expected it, but it just came my way. There you go.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, have a good one. Regis, no honey mustard mayo. Entertainment Weekly. Oh, Schaefer on wheat. Schaefer on whole wheat. Ever since my childhood, my dream was always to open a sandwich shop. I used to knock out a whole giant blimpie with no problems. And so, you know, going into the 12th year of the garment business, I told my partner, you know, maybe we should diversify. And so we picked up the Times, and apparently this was the first shop that we saw. Shortly after that, Dave moves into the neighborhood. And so what I thought was going to be a part-time, you know, flip type of situation turned into a full-time endeavor. Okay, so all of this? How many times I've been on the show? Well, you know, there's this one person who has a database of, you know, late show episodes. I mean, a complete database. And he told me it was 200 and some odd times.
Speaking of food, let's go into Rupert Jee's Hello Deli. There he is, the man himself. Hey, Rupert, how you doing, buddy?
Hi, Dave. How are you? This is what I was told. People tell me that when they're out of ideas, they call me.
There's got to be 100 people in there.
Hi, welcome to the neighborhood. My name is Rupert. Let it go. You never see me cry. They asked me if I want to go skydiving. And I don't know why I agreed to it, but I did. And it turned out to be quite a thrill. One of the most popular skits that I ever did with the Late Show was, I think, what they entitled Fun with Rupert.
He has a microphone, he has an earpiece, he has glasses, he has a disguise, and I talk to Rupert through the walkie-talkie. Hello, Rupert. And we just bother people, don't we?
One where I was disguised as a waiter. I was taking care of these two girls in a very negative way. For example, I would serve her a cup of water with my thumb in her glass, and you know, they got really pissed off.
Thank you. Take that back. Just take it back.
What's the problem now?
What's the problem now?
Put your finger in my glass. Just get out of here, okay?
Well, who are you, the Queen of England?
Well, who are you, the Queen of England? I think it's an honor that I got to work with him. When they first came in, I said to myself, you know, it's futile for me to impress myself upon him because, I mean, you're dealing with the most talented man in the world. There's no way I can, you know, show that I'm better than him. I might as well just be myself. And you know, ironically, that's what worked. I think if I tried to be something other than myself, it never would have worked. Quite often, the Late Show would send celebrities in here. Here is Mary Tyler Moore, a thing that I shot with her. God, who knows how long that was. I think my line that day was, Mary, you've got a cue card stuck on your ass. Engelbert Humperdinck, trying to make a comeback, I guess. And this is him singing with me in the deli. I was thrilled because as a kid growing up, I always wanted to be like him.
Really?
Yeah. That's how old I am. Because of our exposure with the Late Show, we get, of course, a lot of the tourists. They might want to buy one of the Late Show merchandises, or it could be just for an autograph, it could be for breakfast.
Check it out.
Here we go. We're here in Rupert Jee's Hello Deli. Ready to see Dave for the last time.
Last tape, we've been to a few.
Yep.
Very sad.
I used to intern up the corner and would sneak out and see tapings all the time, so I became a Dave regular. And
haven't missed the show in 23 years.
I don't know if that's something you reward, that sort of behavior, but we're pretty
but
weird.
I used to have like 3 VCRs when I go on vacation. I'd have them in all different rooms, so I wouldn't miss a show. And I don't know if I can handle it.
Yep. You're welcome. I was in mourning since the day that he announced his retirement. I think he's got too much energy. And, you know, I don't think he could hang around and fish 7 days a week or ride horses. And I should be happy for him, but from a selfish standpoint, I mean, you know, what he's brought into this neighborhood, what he's given to me, I mean, you just can't put a price on it. It's just priceless. I think, like, this neighborhood will never be the same with Dave leaving.